Hi there, Guy from Bugs and Stuff and GiantSpiders.com. In this short film, we'll take a closer look at an amazing arachnid that some say is the stuff of nightmares, the Tailless Whip Scorpion. I've been lucky enough to have had many encounters with these cool animals during field trips over the years, and it's always a treat to find them. They often live in the same habitat as the tarantulas we're searching for, and it's always a welcome bonus when we come across them. We keep these in captivity too here at Bugs and Stuff HQ, and have been successful in breeding them also. Tailless whip scorpions, sometimes called whip spiders, are arachnids and belong to the order Amblypygii, but they shouldn't be confused with their close relative, the true whip scorpion or vinegaroons. The name Amblypygid means blunt tail and relates to the lack of flagellum or tail that is found in whip scorpions. Their close relatives, the whip scorpions, do indeed have a tail-like structure at the end of their abdomen, which give them their common name. Unlike most arachnids, tailless whip scorpions don't possess any venom or silk glands, and lacking a tail, don't have a sting like their scorpion namesakes. This means they are harmless to humans and never bite, but they may grab your fingers with their short pedipalps if they feel threatened. Over 150 species have so far been described, and they are found in tropical and subtropical regions of the world. They inhabit a range of environments, but are mostly found living in caves and on trees. They're nocturnal in habit, so rarely seen out in the daytime, so it's at night when we come across them while searching for tarantulas. Their flattened bodies are perfect for hiding in the cracks of cave walls and behind loose bark, and if disturbed, they quickly will run for cover. They're ambush predators, using their modified first pair of legs to sense nearby prey. This is why they're called whip scorpions. Those long appendages that look like an insect's antenna, or whips, are in fact their first pair of legs. These are known as antenniform legs and are highly sensitive to movement. The tailless whip scorpion emerges from its retreat at night and slowly moves forward, waving these legs in front of it in search of passing prey. Although, like most other arachnids, they often have 8 eyes, their vision is poor at best. Good eyesight is unnecessary while out hunting at night, so these arachnids rely upon stealth and rapid movement when tackling prey. Once the antenna-form legs come into contact with the prey, the tailless whip scorpion rushes forward to capture it and uses their modified raptorial pedipalps. On true scorpions, these would be the claws, and they are used in a similar way. When at rest, they are folded close to the body, but when in use, they can be rapidly extended to form a wide trap to envelop prey. They are tipped with many thorn-like projections, so are perfect for grabbing fast-moving prey and quickly bringing it towards the mouth and the pedicellus ray or fangs. Prey is typically smaller invertebrates such as cockroaches and crickets, but anything they can overpower is on the menu, including small lizards and some vertebrates. Sex determination is difficult as many species look identical, but a few species can be easy to tell apart once mature. Mature males sometimes have wider pedipalps than the females, and this can be seen in the photograph. The female is on the left and the male on the right. Courtship is similar to their scorpion relatives and involves the male grasping the female's pedipalps and guiding her across a smooth surface onto which he has deposited a stalked spermatophore. This is picked up by the female and the sperm used to fertilize the eggs when ready. After several weeks, females will lay their fertilized eggs into a sac that is carried under the abdomen, and when they eventually hatch, they are carried on the mother's back for several days until they molt and eventually disperse. In captivity, they can sometimes be kept communally, but as with all unnatural communal setups, cannibalism is always a risk, so I recommend you only keep a mating pair together during breeding. Many species are territorial, so make sure you do your research in advance. Lifespan varies between the species, but the more commonly kept types often can live between 5 and 10 years in captivity. Just like other invertebrates, they mold their external skeleton or exoskeleton several times in order to grow. This is a crucial time for tailless whip scorpions, so make sure your enclosure has multiple hiding places and lots of rough vertical surfaces that it can grasp onto in order to mold successfully. Enclosures should be taller rather than wide to accommodate their arboreal lifestyle, and country of origin should be used as a reference when setting temperature and humidity levels. So when we're searching for tarantulas in trees like the one behind me, it's often full of cracks and holes. Now inside those holes you'll often find other animals, and this one on my hand is an amblypygid. It's also known as a tailless whip scorpion. It's got what we call antenna form legs because it's actually an arachnid, so it doesn't actually have antenna, and it uses those legs to sense its way around its environment. And when it's out at dusk on the edge of the bark at night time, when it touches anything such as a cricket or a cockroach, that alerts it to the presence of its prey. It's another arachnid. It does have 8 eyes, it does have 8 legs, but unlike scorpions, of which it gets its common name, it doesn't have a tail, so it's completely non-venomous. On the ends of its raptorial pedipalps, there's large spikes which it uses to grasp a hold of its prey to bring towards the mouth. So being completely flat, also in profile, means during the daytime it can hide in the cracks on the walls or in the bark of the trees, as we're finding in this area here today. So, despite their somewhat frightening appearance, tailless whip scorpions are anything but.